climate change is not just about putting in renewable energy. It's also about sustainability. So today, which is just beginning of the winter, we have already seen over like 300 birds coming in. You can't direct the birds to do something, right? I mean, this is wildlife, this is nature, right? You see, so we've done something right.
Every winter in Taiwan, one of the most expected sights to behold is the endangered species, black-faced spoonbill. In Chiayi, moreover, next to them is a remarkable solar project named Mingus by Vena Energy, independent power producer from Singapore that outshines its peers in Asia Pacific. Today, I am pleased to be joined by XS Koo, head of Vena Energy Taiwan, who will be sharing with us how Mingus can marry business operations and environmental protection in harmony. So could you tell us, you know, what Vena Energy is about?
Vena Energy is largest independent power producer now across Asia Pacific, now in the region. We have over 16 gigawatts of projects that's under construction and operational and under development. Other than Taiwan, we're in Korea, in Japan, now in Philippines, Thailand, Indonesia, India, and Australia. Now, and in all these places, we have a mixed portfolio of not only renewable energy, which is in solar, but also in wind. In some areas, we have renewable hybrid energies and energy storage solutions, which is also renewable. As from a company perspective now, we have a corporate mission against climate change. Climate change is not just about putting in renewable energy. It's also about sustainability, thing which is our primary mission. Now, having said that, connecting into Taiwan, the opportunity on being able to work together with Taiwanese government, in this case, it was a Bureau of Energy, to develop this Mingus project that you just mentioned. We want to demonstrate to the community, to the world, to Taiwan, energy transition, not only is talking about converting from not too clean energy to really clean or green energy. Also protect the nature and the biodiversity. And through the whole process on developing, construction, and finally to operating, we consistently weigh in the importance of ESG, what we need to do to protect the environment, to engage the community. Above all, if we can even make the world better, we'll do that.
And so I want to move further with this Mingus project. Mm-hmm. Remember, from a bird's eye view, you can see this huge Mingus project.
Yep.
And it resembles the outline of a black-faced spoonbill. Mm-hmm. And beneath the surface, we can see a lot of solar panels that generate over 100 gigawatts hours annually.
Yes.
Could you share with us what Mingus project has done right and is meaning for the industry? Yeah.
If you get into like the CO2 reduction right now, and that amount will be close to like about over 60,000 tons a year right now of CO2 reduction, okay, decarbonization, which is fantastic. In addition to that, if you convert it into a number of households that you power, it'll be about 28,000 households that you power just with that plant. That's number one. Now, we have all the technology. We have the benefit of our regional solar team that can bring the latest technology and tell us how we could design in an earthquake environment with a stronger environment and get optimal generation. We have our wind team also across that supports our entire group in terms of ensuring designs and performance are optimized. We have the blessing of the community, the birds association, the academics from the university now, and the experts in the government group to work together with us with a common mission towards how can we not only build a sustainable energy plant, but also ensure that this plant, whatever risk that it might have been created on biodiversity, on environment, is adequately mitigated. It could either be remains the same or bad. I think that positive mindset is very important, because I think what usually any living creature, now let's put it human beings as an example, we usually fear change. Things has been like this for a while, and if we change, now what if it doesn't turn out well? There's a natural fear in that. What I'm really pleased about in the Mingus development is that we're able to get a team of experts with a common mission to overcome the fear. And you overcome the fear in the sense of not rejecting it, but in the sense of looking towards what if, what could have gone wrong, what are the risks, what can we do differently to make sure that this risk is mitigated. We build a biodiversity ecological conservation area, actively incorporate a balance of what is needed to the migratory birds that flies across. And at the same time, also look into the water level. The drought situation or wet situation, it is in an optimal depth, making it more like an oasis for the black-faced spoonbill and different types of birds. And I guess that's why we are seeing more and more birds coming in, right? You can't direct the birds to do something, right? I mean, this is wildlife, this is nature, right? So natures will go to where the attractions are, so we clearly did something right. And even as of today, which is just beginning of the winter, we have already seen over like 300 birds coming in and a run rate of about close to 30 to 40 per day. Right, see, so I think within this season towards the next May, it's going to be another record season. Right, see, so I think hopefully as this project goes, the black-faced spoonbill might even be no longer endangered.
I think that's fantastic. You maintain the relationship with the local people and the migrant birds while you produce a lot of renewable energy. So yes, it's like win-win situation, yes, for many stakeholders. Yeah. I want to dig further because we talk about, quite widely the implications for the environment and for people in the neighborhood, and also, you know, your missions as a power supplier in the region. What does ESG mean to you? Can you clarify?
In ESG, what we look at from an environment perspective is that now we have to make sure whatever we do, our corporate mission is to fight against climate change. If the mission is to decarbonize, and by introducing, which is what we do, renewable energy, we have to make sure environment is protected. That's the E. Now, on the social side, it's really ensuring that wherever we go, we engage the local community. Even in our Vena Taiwan mission in Chinese, we said, 在地生根实现绿能. We believe in localizing, we believe in engaging the community. That's our mindset. Our team will be able to tell you for every site that we are either developing or we are currently operating in, what activities that we actually have towards long-term engagement. This way on the S side. On governance sides, it's clearly the G part. Right now, I think being an international player, which is usually on the international standards, maybe the policies aren't that clear. The bar may be low. But that doesn't mean that, okay, now we lower our standards, okay, because the bar is low. If our standards are higher, we will stick to the higher standard and we will slowly lobby and encourage. We need to engage to raise the bar so that it is for the good of the people, for the good of the economy. Right now, you might be aware of, we have other than Mingus, we have successfully finished construction. We also have other projects that's under construction. Now, in this year, we have close to about 800,000 construction hours equivalent of our projects that has been accumulated as of end of October. In this 800,000, we have zero accident. You can be lucky for 100 hours, but I don't think you can just count on luck for 800,000 hours. So our team is conscious about safety and we believe in the safety culture now and we don't take risks. I think that's also part of a mix between governance and social that we believe as a conviction in ESG.
What about the internal communication between stakeholders? We just talk about your communication with external parties like governments or the local communities. What about, let's say, horizontally between different branches or internally within Vena Energy Taiwan? How do you communicate transparently and also effectively?
We are consistently challenging ourselves. We learn and we continue to improve. That's our culture. We have an active feedback system every week. We encourage them to do so. Right, so out of every 3 months, we'll pick and say who has the best ideas, which is implemented that benefits the company and the person will receive an award. Now, in addition to that, we do have weekly meetings internally amongst our different groups together to discuss issues and opportunities, concur towards a clear next step that, you know, we move forward on a weekly basis. You know, we started off with a team of 10, 5 years ago now, and we are a team of 70. Okay, now it's not big, but we're still a decent sized family. Everyone rolls up their sleeve, work together and works really hard because they subscribe to and believe to in. They believe in protecting the environment. They believe in green energy, fighting climate change. And this is what Vena is all about. This is what they have strong conviction on. And therefore, they are really proud to be in the company. So I really appreciate the great team that we have. Work seamlessly together and also with the mindset of safety and with the mindset of continuous improvement.
I can see that the company is very concerned with employees' feedback, and you create this feedback loop that enables people's opinions be heard, mm-hmm. and also you make sure that their safety and a lot of aspects are covered. Mm-hmm. So I want to move on to our final questions, mm-hmm. Because being part of Taiwan's energy transition mm-hmm. towards, you know, renewable energy, mm-hmm. 20% of it by 2025, mm-hmm. and I want to bring this up because last year Vena Energy Taiwan actually sold solar power to TSMC. Mm-hmm. I want to ask you what your plans are towards the future, because it seems the landscape of Taiwan is constantly changing. How do you weigh in all that and bring your next plans?
Yeah. Now, in terms of where we are looking at where we are and towards the future, and how you see the corporate power agreement to TSMC as part of it. As we go on a mission of fighting climate change with transitioning into renewable energy, we are blessed with the fact that the Taiwanese government has a clear mandate and KPI towards denuclearization and phasing in renewable to make Taiwan green and more self-sufficient in terms of imported fossil fuel and energy source. So that was encouraging incentive for us to get more involved, more engaged towards the energy transition led by the government, and we want to deeply pursue that and support it, okay, now because it's the right thing. We see the mission of the government towards the renewable KPIs is to jumpstart the direction towards energy transition. But what's really going to carry it forward with momentum over the life of tens of years to come is really the RE100. Now, because you start looking at RE100, the mission is 2030, 2040, 2050, depending on the stages of each of these countries. BC last year was we were the first selling of direct green energy to TSMC, which is one of the major global supply chain in the semiconductor industry. It wasn't easy because it's unprecedented. There was the regulations, the process, and all the things were not clear. As I said earlier on, we are blessed with the partners, with TSMC, with Bureau of Energy, with Ministry of Economic Affairs. Everyone is driven by the mission and says this is the right thing. We have to sit down, finding a solution, figure it out, and make it happen is what's important that will make this a success.
Well, thank you very much for sharing. It's fantastic to know the story of Vena Energy Taiwan. I really look forward to the future moves from you.
Thank you. Yeah, I think I clearly see we have a long way to go. The technology is evolving. The community is also evolving to embrace.
And more aware.
Yeah, together we'll all make it happen and we'll make the world a better place to live.
Unprecedented and all the best.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.